Hi, Emily. It's Catherine. The murder at the old lighthouse in my town was just labeled a cold case. It might sound silly, but I was hoping the cops might find a connection between the case and my husband's death. He was the lighthouse caretaker when he died, and now, I just don't know. Would you check it out for your podcast? If you're interested, send me a picture of your ID card so I can get the local police to make you a press badge.
I'm so glad you're here. I've been prepping for my photography workshop, but I found one of the slides about the case for you. Feel free to look around for anything you might need. I hope the slides filled you in on the lighthouse's history. Roger always loved how mysterious the atmosphere was there. There's a museum near the lighthouse. The owner, Jonathan Starberg, knew Roger well. You can visit him after talking to the police. If I didn't have this workshop coming up, I'd drive you to the station and introduce you to Officer Berg. He can be a real pain, but don't take it personally.
Hello, I'm Taylor Berg. You must be Mrs. Malcolm's friend, the one with the murder podcast. I'd show you the reports, but I have a lot of work to get done before lunch. Sorry. If I were you, I'd only look for the information I really needed. The town has its secrets. Be careful. Andy Cobberg didn't see anything. We suspected him at first, but he had an alibi. You can listen to his story for yourself. The shortest way to the motel is through the parking lot. Also, thanks for the lunch.
Welcome to the Seaside Motel. You're one of those annoying journalists. I told the police I didn't see anything. Case closed. Listen, lady, just forget about the case. That lighthouse is cursed, and you can't trust the police. Where did you find that? Okay, you got me. I lied to the police about my alibi to keep my second family a secret, okay? I was at a school competition that night. But there's something wrong with that lighthouse anyway. People see spooky things there all the time. We got some binoculars out back. I bet if you go use them, you'll see something too.
You must be Emily Smith. Jonathan Starberg, museum owner. Catherine told me you might pay me a visit. I didn't see anything strange outside. Feel free to wait for the police here. We have a fascinating exhibition about the treasures of the lighthouse. Oh, and here's a small souvenir. Yeah, I was good friends with Roger, Catherine's husband. He found a vintage clock in the lighthouse once and restored it to give to the museum. He was generous like that. We need a laptop for the CCTV, but something's wrong with the power strip.
I've got some old spare parts in my car from the office. Feel free to see if there's anything useful while I talk to Jonathan. You're very determined, Miss Smith. But be careful. The last thing this lighthouse needs is another death.
Could you give Catherine the key to the boat storage? Roger left it in the lighthouse before he died. I can't tell you how many hours he spent on that boat just thinking about life.
Thank you.
please, forgive the mess. I haven't had time to tidy up since the workshop ended. Roger made me a similar charm for my bracelet. I know it's somewhere around here. Could you check the box on top of the fireplace? I'll check the drawers. This is the bracelet. You can take it if it will help your investigation. I can't thank you enough for all your help, Emily. And please, be very careful. Call me in an hour. If I don't hear from you, I'll call the police.
Emily, you wanted to explore the lighthouse, right? I have some things to take care of, but you're welcome to have a look around.
Thank you.
Emily, What's going on? I'm calling the police.
You should have stayed out of my business. Though it's not that big of a deal. No one will be surprised when there's another accident at the lighthouse.
Open the door! You're only making things worse!
You can't escape me, Emily!